Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is BuzzBrock30. If you happen to have stumbled upon the thumbnail and read it before clicking on the video beforehand, then you can already assume as to which path I'm taking with this video in particular. No, this isn't a trailer breakdown of the Red Dead Redemption 2 gameplay that you've seen in all of its glory with the arrows and the circles and all the small little tidbits that you may see in other thumbnails. Rather, this is going to be more of a discussion and an opinion that goes over a certain topic that I'm sure you guys are already aware of, and that is, Red Dead Redemption 2 is not Grand Theft Auto 5. I know, it's, shocking. Do they look somewhat similar in terms of gameplay? A bit, yes. Do they both have a dynamic setting? Yes. Will Red Dead Redemption 2 incorporate certain elements or mechanics from previous Rockstar titles? Oh, most definitely. But at the end of the day, both games, and here's the kicker, will be different from each other, more or less. We know this, but do we truly understand this? Now, let's get one thing clear. Everything that is currently present in Grand Theft Auto 5 will not be present in Red Dead Redemption 2. This is certain, as well as stating the obvious, of course. Weapons will be different. Modes of transportation, different. The characters will also be different, and the environment, well, you already know where I'm getting at. Look at it like this. It'll be a new, fresh start for anyone who is looking to get away from the big city that is Los Santos. Like getting off the boat and attempting to start a new life while coincidentally getting dragged down into a world of crime and corruption. It'll not only be completely new to everyone, giving individuals a chance to get adjusted to a new but familiar lifestyle with countless opportunities, but to also start developing new techniques along the way. But you do have to be wary that not everyone is in favor of transitioning over to said new lifestyle. It's like what I stated in my Assassin's Creed video a few weeks ago in regards to change. To put it in a clear statement, change is inevitable. It's going to happen whether we like it or not. It can be good or it can be bad. And with that being said, a lot of people probably won't like the idea of cosplaying as cowboys and outlaws, not only because it won't have the technological advances that everyone is already so used to at this point, but because they honestly believe that Grand Theft Auto 5 is already better than Red Dead Redemption 2, despite the game not being released yet. I suppose it is due to the fact that to this day, Grand Theft Auto is still one of the most played games even after being released for 5 years. It's one of the few top-selling games currently, most notably on the PlayStation 4 console. It managed to achieve over 90 million sales, and it also generated a revenue of $6 billion and counting.
Hey, that's pretty good.
So, for anyone who thinks GTA is dead and gone, you're Red Dead wrong. So, I'm going to go out on a limb here and say most of the revenue they managed to acquire was from the multiplayer counterpart GTA Online and how it's currently their cash cow. In no way am I surprised that they shocked the monetary bonuses with the pre-order of Red Dead Redemption 2, which goes to show that even after its release, they still have a few ideas up their sleeves for future content. Don't get me wrong, the recent update for After Hours looks fun, but because it's yet another grind fest, with its horrifying vehicles I might add, I can honestly see as to why most people want to change a pace. And with all that crap out of the way, the real question is this. Are people going to be holding high expectations for Red Dead Redemption 2 when the game releases? Oh yes, they most certainly are. It makes me wonder if the devs even have that much faith that Red Dead will bring home the bacon, considering the main fact that the game is going to be completely different and how they have to change up their strategies in the long run. It brings me back to the conversation that I had with Zorvan a couple of months ago about seeing the bigger picture and how most of us forget the small details to follow up with it. All the gameplay made me want to bust a nut. You have to remember that what you see is not what you may necessarily get, and that things could change from now up until the actual release date. You remember how long it took for the heist update to be released in GTA Online? Pepperidge Farm remembers. Speaking of online, I'm just going to assume that since we're in a different timeline, a lot of the elements may be drastically changed and not be the big grind fest that we're already used to. Hell, I wouldn't even be surprised if they actually implemented certain mechanics from the original Red Dead Redemption multiplayer and GTA Online altogether, just to make sure that the game lives up to the higher standards that other past Rockstar games have made. And if that's the case, they're going to have to release a hell of a lot of content to try and make it on par with its modern day counterpart. The only thing I ask and hope they will take into consideration is to take their time with said content so that we as the consumer won't get bored and burned off from the game immediately afterwards. Recently, GT Amon talked about drip feeding possibilities in one of his videos in regards to Red Dead Redemption 2, and the shit hits home.
Personally, really hoping as well is that they will take a very different approach to drip feeding and actually learn from what they've done in GTA Online. Personally, I'm quite alright when it comes to drip feeding. Drip feeding to me is a way to get more content out from the same DLC and not dump everything in one go.
So, to reiterate, would you rather have DLC content that's drip-fed for a few weeks at the most so that you have something to look forward to and get prepared for it, or would you rather have all the DLC content at once, complete everything there is to offer, and become bored to the point where we all start bitching and complaining to Rockstar about when the next DLC update is coming, because trust me, it's going to happen. Also, I think there's one more thing that needs to be addressed, and that is, you know, how about we try and not ask for impossible content? I know somewhere out there in the world, someone has an idea that they want to try to give to Rockstar that's just going to be completely oblivious and dumb. I mean, come on now. We don't need no chrome horses with the golden hooves so that we can flex on other players and try to prove a point, nor do we need protective buckets on our head because some of us can't take it in raw. Deadass. But that's basically all there is to it, so yeah. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Love you all, and peace.